For the N2O3 Lewis structure, we have 28 valence electrons. Nitrogen is the most electronegative element, so we'll put both of the nitrogens there in the center, and then we'll put the oxygens around them. We have three oxygens. We'll put two electrons between atoms to form chemical bonds. We've used 8 valence electrons, and then we'll go around the oxygens on the outside. So we have 8, 10, and 26, and we'll put the last pair right here on the nitrogen, 28. So we've used all 28 valence electrons, and you can see the oxygens, they all have 8 valence electrons, so their outer shells are full. But the nitrogens, each nitrogen only has 6 valence electrons. So we need to form double bonds in order to give those nitrogens octets. Let's move two of these valence electrons here from the oxygen in with the nitrogen to form a double bond. The oxygen still has 8 valence electrons, but now the nitrogen has 8 valence electrons as well. So we'll do the same thing on the other side. Again, the oxygen has an octet, and the nitrogen also has a full outer shell with 8 valence electrons. And we're also still using 28 valence electrons. If we calculated the formal charges, we'd find that they were zero on all the atoms except the nitrogen and the oxygen. We'd like our formal charges to be as close to zero as possible for each of the atoms. We could draw this structure a number of ways. For instance, we could put the double bond between the nitrogen, and that would work as well. However, this is the Lewis structure for N2O3 that has the formal charges closest to zero. And it makes sense, the negative 1 is on the oxygen, it's more electronegative than nitrogen. And the net formal charge for the entire molecule, if we add the negative 1 and the positive 1 up, is 0. And that makes sense because N2O3 is not a charged ion, it's just a regular molecule. So that's the Lewis structure for N2O3. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.